was the loyal officers were the body, the elected body. They call them the loyal officers. They were there to protect the populations and so forth. And they had elected a fellow by the name of Zemu, could be spelled X-E-M-U, to the supreme ruler. And they were about to unelect him. And he took the last moments he had in office to really goof the floof. Yes, I don't blame you for dropping something. And he took these last moments to really upset it. He, of course, had several key birds who were close to him. He was a suppressive, the end-all suppressives. He got these administrators and so on, and heads of planets in various positions and places. He picked out all the cowboys in the white hat, and he got rid of them first, fast, and then troops, not knowing what the hell they were doing, but fed all kinds of false orders, were fed in against the population to pick them up, one after the other. One of the mechanisms they used was to tell them to come in for an income tax investigation. And the United States just copies income tax. They're just R6, they're a bunch of dramatizing psychotics, these guys. So in they went, and the troops started slaughtering them, and then the troops, of course, were ordered out to get a hold of certain bodies of renegade troops, which were ordered to get certain bodies of bad troops, and they shot each other up and implanted each other and wiped it out. They were making billiard balls out of these places. They were imported. They were actually, the trick was to shoot somebody, disable somebody, very often a needle into a lung, and at the same time to hit him with frozen alcohol and glycol, which preparation is guaranteed to pick up a thing. All he had to do was pick him up and put him in a refrigerator, and they had him, boy. As he tried to exteriorize from the body, there he was, frozen. And they threw him into collection points, boxed them up in boxes, threw them into space planes, which are the exact DC-8s. The DC-8 airplane is the exact copy of the space plane of that day. And no difference, except the DC-8 had fans, propellers on it, and the space plane didn't. And they threw them into refrigerated units and so on, in view of the fact that Einstein was absolutely right. No man can't go faster than the speed of sound. What a lot of our speed of light, which is a bunch of balderdash. The length of time from the planet Coltis to the planet Tigiak, which is the name of this planet, was 9 weeks, and you'll see that it's many light years. Coltis is one of the planets, and is to this day one of the planets of the North Star, Polaris. And people were ferried in here by the billions and the billions and the billions, and they were ferried in here with boxes, and they were put in boxes and stacked around. And the people who were on this planet already just caught it in the teeth. They weren't bothered. Nobody bothered to pick them up. They just shot their administrators from guns and shot their control points out. And they took these people in boxes and so forth, and they dumped them, and then they set off hydrogen bombs on the top of each primary volcano there is on this particular planet. And when they blew up, it blew the Thetans into the air, and after the bomb, an electronic ribbon, which also was a type of standing wave, was erected over the area. The tremendous winds of the planet blew every Thetan there was straight into those particular vacuum zones which had been created. These were brought down, packed up, and put in front of projection machines, which with sound and color pictures first gave them the implant which you know as clearing course, and then a whole track implanted which you know as OT2.